stormed out of an anger management therapy session. Mike P. Addick.
Drop in violent crime when it snows is a terrible place to start a rant. I'm a high school English teacher. They're here. So I'm a high school English teacher, which is great, except for I mostly teach literature because grammar is dead to us as a society, especially for our children. It's true. I love grammar. It's dead. I read these papers and, you know, they inexplicably, they don't use capital letters ever. There's no punctuation whatsoever. And they learned from Twitter and texting, so you don't need all that stuff. Lots of words inexplicably have numbers or symbols in them. And whoever invented emojis. I hate that guy. I love his product, but I hate that guy. So, I taught Baltimore for 7 years, in the city, like The Wire, except way more real. So I taught Baltimore for 7 years, in the city, and now I teach in like this fancy pants charter school up north of Charlotte. It's a terrible move. I have to listen to my students now, and, you know, I'll ask a kid, like, hey, why don't you have a girlfriend? But, well, Mr. Peter, I don't have time for a girlfriend, because, you know, between school and soccer and volunteering for my church, I don't have time. It brings me back to my Baltimore days. When I would hear such things as, man, I am so paranoid, I wear rubbers in my dreams. Now, my students will miss like a week here and there for like a hunting trip or a cruise. There it was, I'm gonna miss Tuesday because I gotta meet my PO. A PO is a parole officer. This is a person you must check in with after you've been convicted of a crime. I'm a high school teacher. It is worth noting, though, the teardrop tattooed hall monitors would miss for the exact same reasons. I really miss those guys. They were awesome. You know, the other great thing was I'm lazy by nature. So having 75 students where like only 9 of them would ever do a given assignment was awesome. The things I've had to say are almost as amazing as the things I've had to hear. So it's things like, can I hand in two of the same assignment? Because I did one and I did another and I think one's better, but I don't know what you're gonna think, so can I hand in two? Can I just say things like, no. Because that's too much work for me. And I don't like you. Days up in the Baltimore, I would get to say things like, "Hey, Devontae, get off the table. Put your shirt back on. And we told you underwear is part of the dress code." Rest in peace, Devontae. Challenging my students, challenging them, telling them their gangs are dumb. And just try and stab me. My insurance there came with free ambulance rides. That's what we in the literary community call foreshadowing. Hopefully my students are clapping because they know foreshadowing is. here, up in the, you know, in the suburbs of Charlotte, I probably won't need those ambulance rides. none of this is normal. I grew up in Connecticut in the suburbs. Yeah, you're all happy because you left. I grew up in Connecticut in the suburbs, and you know, most of the people I went to high school with ended up being, you know, mediocre achievers. Drunken frat boy date rapist douchebags, or potential mass murderers. Yeah, that one was weird in the class too. Fortunately, teaching has brought me to and sort of reintroduced me to one of my other great loves, beer. Beer is ridiculous now in the last couple of years. Back in the day, drinking beer, you're like, wow, this tastes like beer because there's nothing to compare it to. Now, it comes in all different flavors. They got like hoppy beer, fruity beer, chocolatey beer, and nutty beer. There's a beer that tastes like a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. Ridiculously good. My favorites are the ones that have like puns for names, especially literary puns. There's one called a Hopwork Orange. I love the hop puns. Hop-pocalypse now. You drink a hop-pocalypse now, you go up to the bar like, "Hey bartender, I'll take a hop-pocalypse now." Because really, I just hope the rest of the night, my burps are gonna taste like a pine tree. So, the beer is great. I have friends, there's an app for beer now, which is because there's an app for basically everything in our lives. There's an app for beer now that lets you keep track of what you've had to drink because there's like 50 bajillion different kinds of beer now. I have friends that are on this app. They're not like writers per se. I'm not trying to be particular because I'm an English guy, but they're not like writers. I'm not that great at it. But man, their beer reviews are like poetry. It's like, contain the hint of flowery notes. It's elegant, smooth on the back of the tongue. You're drinking a peanut butter and jelly beer, and all that's doing is getting you drunk and reminding you of your childhood. That's it. So despite the beer hobby, I'm trying to lose weight, which is going amazingly. Because I'm wearing black, it's okay. So I have this method. there's an app that I use because I'm entirely reliant on my cell phone to exist. So there's an app I use, and it basically keeps track of like everything I eat and drink, and it checks the calories, right? And it tells me like, hey, you're getting close to your calories, you're doing a great job, whatever. So here's the thing, beer is high in calories. So what I end up doing on days that I know I'm gonna have some beers, get up in the morning, have like a piece of toast, go to the gym, just kill myself like 2 hours. I'm killing it. Sweat, disgusting. It's great. I go home and I just plow down chicken and kale. Just plowing down the chicken. Yeah, oh yeah. Then it's beer time, so it's all over. So as I'm doing this, I sit down, I have a couple beers, and I'm flipping through the app, and I basically report to the app everything that I'm eating and drinking, which is cool, and most days ends up like, hey, congratulations, if you keep this up in 5 weeks, you'll be 10 pounds down from where you are now. I'm like, great, sweet, thanks. Except on beer days. Beer days, basically, way to go. In 5 weeks, you're gonna gain 20 pounds. That's when the app hurts my feelings. Some drunken words hurt more. Then I get sad hungry. You're laughing, you know what sad hungry is. So I get sad hungry. I go home and I eat all the crap I've been like avoiding all day because I know I'm gonna drink the beer. And then the app gets even more sad and it's so terrible. So, you know, the cool thing about the app is it tells me like, hey, good job, you know, congratulations, tomorrow you can have the same thing you had today, all that chicken and kale. But don't drink the beer. But that app may never let me eat a jelly donut again. Because it won't let me do what I want to do ever. But damn it, if I'm not going to drink a beer that tastes like a jelly donut. It's way better that way anyway. You know, drinking. Sometimes I grade papers when I've had some beers. It's involuntary, because at that point everything is. But it's actually better. I think it works out better for my students. I'm more forgiving. Normally I'm kind of like an a-hole about it, but I'm much more forgiving if I had a couple beers. And I'll read a paper and be like, oh, like today Thomas decided not to use any punctuation. That'd be, that's good. Decided he didn't want to, you know, use capital letters. C minus. I don't really like Alex that much, so. And I'm totally thrown out of that other paper he wrote. The great ones, though. 5-page essay. You gave me one paragraph. Jane, you, my friend, get an A for not harshing on my buzz. Said, if anyone would like a parent conference, I'll be at the bar.